guy that we're going to look to make plays. And you know, then there's Josh Cooper and Hubert Anium. Both have had good fall practices, and as well as you know, a guy like Tracy Moore, who's you know, a freshman, but he's came in, he's learned. I don't think I've ever seen him drop a pass since he's been here. Anything that hits his hands, he's going to catch. And so, you know, we look for all those guys to help us out, and then obviously all the tight ends as well. And you know, kind of just by committee with those guys, you know, outside of this.
The Georgia guys last week were talking about how tight quarters are here at the state. And they played 109,000 fans are a mile away from the state. Right. Here, it's like a basketball.
Right.
People talk about the difference in this place and just about every other place.
Yeah, it's you know, this place in Colorado, I think, are the tightest ones, you know, to the sideline, and the fans are right on top of you. And I know it's going to be loud on Saturday, but you know, Georgia's played in big games, and they've, you know, played at LSU, they played at Florida, you know, they play at, I guess they don't play at Florida, but they play, you know, in the SEC against, on the road against good teams. And so I don't think any of this is going to intimidate them, and it's just going to be, you know, a regular road game for them.
Zach, college football seems to be the only sport where everybody's talking about this conference versus that conference. Is there much thought on your end? Let's represent the Big 12 well, going against the other school that's regarded as top league.
You know, there is a little bit. We don't really think about it a whole lot, but you know, you do hear about the SEC and the Big 12, and you know, the defenses in the SEC, offenses in the Big 12. But we really don't read too much into it. We do want to represent our conference, and hopefully we can play well on Saturday to do so.
Do you feel like there's any truth to the statement that it might take offenses a little while to shake the rust off, more so than defenses anyway, coming into the season?
I mean, there can be. I mean, there's you know, there's times where defenses, you know, haven't got a lot of live drills of tackling, and so they struggle, you know, tackling in space and things like that. So I think it can go both ways, but you know, as offense, we feel good where we're at, and obviously this week will be good to kind of fine tune some things and be ready to go.
Do you guys like having a tune-up game, maybe a smaller school, to kind of shake the rust off and get into it? Or are you fine with opening up the season with a game that's huge?
I'm fine
like
with opening up with whoever. I mean, it's great to have a great team like Georgia right off the bat, just to kind of see where you're at. And so, you know, we're excited about the matchup, and you know, glad that, you know, Georgia's his first game.
Did you see much variation last year in the way opponents tried to cover Dez Bryant, or was it pretty consistent, and would you expect Georgia to try to
do it? Yeah, you know, that's probably the biggest question mark going in, is how they'll play Dez. Last year there was, you know, started off the season, you know, guys, you know, they were singling them up, and we took advantage of that a lot, and we started seeing, you know, more double cover, safety over the top, and things like that. And so, you know, we still were able to find a way to get them the ball, and hopefully we can continue to do that. And we're kind of just, you know, wait and see, you know, how they play us, and you know, if they choose to single them up or however they choose, you know, hopefully we'll be able to give them the ball, and as well as you know, spread around to some other guys.
Are you confident that, you know, there's a difference in the way you run in practice, the way you run when you try to score a touchdown? Have you cut loose to that extent and are confident that the legs could be better?
Yeah, you know, last week was really the first week that I, you know, kind of let it loose a little bit on some runs and kind of opened up a little bit, and I'll continue to do so, you know, even more this week. And so, you know, I feel fine running, and obviously it's a whole lot different for a quarterback. I haven't been hit, you know, since last season. And so I'm sure once that first hit comes, I'll be ready to go.
Do you expect a pretty high-scoring game Saturday?
I don't know. I mean, it could go either way. I mean, both defenses have the capability of stopping both offenses, and both offenses can score points. And so it really is, you kind of just never know what to expect, and we'll just kind of wait and see.
The other guys, when they describe Georgia, the first word that comes out of their mouth is physical. Is that what you see when you watch them in film?
Yeah, I think physical and speed. I mean, their defense is fast. They got good linebackers, great front seven in general. And then, you know, at the back end, their safeties, corners, they can all run. And so I think, you know, they're a typical SEC defense, and you know, very, very good, you know, at every spot. And so we're definitely going to have our hands full.
So for 7 months, there's been all this speculation about how much immediate impact Bill Young can have on your defense. to a man, all the defensive guys I talked to, I'll say the most pronounced difference will be in the pass rush. Is that what you've seen?
Yeah, I've seen a big improvement in that regard, and it seems like there's always a guy that if he's not right there, then they're right around your feet. As a quarterback, I mean, that can affect you. Just the slightest bit, if there's somebody right in your face and forces a throw to go high or something like that. And so I think they've done a great job, doing that this fall camp and last spring. And
you're seeing that from the front four guys?
Yeah, they've been getting the front four, and then when they do blitz, they can get pressure on you. But they've been able to do it with the front four guys, which is great. And so hopefully they can just carry that over to the season.
Good they've been on the road under Coach Rick.
I have heard some things about they're a great road team and so we expect that this is going to be no different for them. They've played in big road games, and so they're not going to get caught up in all the hype about the game and the crowd and things like that, and so we know they'll be ready to go.
Didn't you catch a pass in Georgia?
I think I threw one.
Bob, did you? Is that what it was?
I ran one. It was the first series, I think. I threw one to him, and then I ended up running one, and then Savage scored on the next play. I think our second touchdown or something.
So are you 100%? I mean, there's nothing holding you back at all?
Yeah, definitely. I've been 100% for the last couple weeks now, and it's been a matter of just getting back into. Getting back in the groove of running and taking off, when I feel comfortable doing it, and so I feel fine, and just can't wait to let it cut loose on Saturday.
What's going to be said after that game 2 years ago that you guys weren't ready for the big time? How do you feel about this team now in that regard?
I think we're there. I feel like we're there, and our team from a talent standpoint, compared to that in 07 is it's not even comparable, and so. I feel like we're a talented team, and we've been through a lot as a team. And last year was great for us, playing in big games and playing well in big games. And so I expect our team to come out Saturday and forget about all the hype and stuff like that, and we'll just be ready to go.
Are these the type of games as a college kid coming up and a high school kid that you look at and just really wanting to play?
Oh, definitely. I mean, anytime you play in a big time game on. ABC, ESPN. I mean, it's all you dream about, growing up as a kid, wanting to play college football. And so, we're going to take advantage of our opportunity and just have a lot of fun with it.
How much did that loss hurt?